And now the Ring of Fire, the last solar eclipse of this year and this decade, which is taking place this morning. Visible in several parts of India, including Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, in several parts of the Middle East. This is the third and last solar eclipse of this year. A solar eclipse occurs when the moon passes between the Earth and the moon, thereby totally or partly obscuring the sun for a viewer on Earth, generating huge interest among the sky watchers. The partial eclipse began at 8:04 a.m. when the moon touched the sun's edge, and at 9:24 a.m. the annular phase started and the full eclipse became visible. At 9:26 a.m. the maximum eclipse occurred when the moon was closest to the center of the sun. By 9:27 a.m. the full eclipse ended, and by 11:05 in few minutes the moon will leave the edges of the sun, ending the partial eclipse. The total eclipse will last for 3.12 minutes when the annular solar eclipse takes place. Sky watchers were advised to use safety equipment and proper techniques to view this event, as the infrared and ultraviolet rays of the sun can cause severe retinal damage. And now let's go across to my colleague Nihal Kidwai, who's joining us from Bangalore to share the latest about the eclipse in the city. Nihal, a lot of interest has been generated by this last solar eclipse of the year. How is the city of Bangalore taking this? What action are you seeing there among the sky watchers?
See, here at the Nehru Planetarium, a special arrangement was made, and people had business. Even kids, small kids, had also thronged the place. But here at the town hall, as you can see, a few people are still sitting here, and the general perception is that during the process of this celestial event, nothing should be eaten, nothing should be drunk, and it is, as per the religious observation, it is not good, it is not advisable. But here, some of the prominent citizens of Bangalore came here together, they ate here, they had tea, they had coffee, and right now with us is Mr. Balan, one of the prominent lawyers of Karnataka High Court. Sir, you also defied this general principle, and you also had some food here, I seen you. Yeah. What message do you want to convey?
See, today we wanted to give a message to the people of India. This is Surya Grahana is a superstitious belief. This Shastra is false. It is also cheating. See, today they organize so many homas, pujas, punaskaras in so many temples. Ultimately, it is the Jyotishta and the Brahmanas are making too much of money. See, the fact remains, the concept and the scheme of puja punaskara is that the world is geocentric. But 450 years back, it was Bruno, Galileo, Copernicus, they said it's a false belief. It is a heliocentric, not geocentric. There is nothing like Surya Grahana.
Sir, what all did you eat?
I ate morning, I ate mutton, I ate chicken at home. At the same time, here I ate cake, I ate fruit. Nothing is going to happen.
But sir, astrologers say that what all you ate, in fact you ate, you had food, but in fact you ate or you consumed poison.
That's what they say. Do you feel, did you find anyone admitted in the hospital? During Deepavali, many sustained injury got it admitted. After Grahana, did you find anyone going to the hospital? I ate today morning mutton. What will happen to me? Right now I had mutton. I wanted to, I had a soup, cold soup, leg soup. What will happen? This is a food. These are all false belief. It has intention, supremacy of certain human being, inferiority of certain human being. We don't accept.
Right, Nehan.
It is we to create scientific temper. We mobilized here, assembled here.
So that is why they had assembled here. Logical Indians, you can see here, still a few people are sitting here, and they are clearly saying that it is a celestial event, it is a science, something related to the science and not religion.